Hey everyone, it's Ashley. Welcome back to my channel. I am super excited today because I am playing around with some goodies from the stamp market, which is my new obsession and has been for quite a while. I'm going to be using the diagonal pinstripe background stamp as well as the paper hug die. And this die comes with the shadow and the actual word die, so you can put the words right on top. And it's interesting because some of the letters in the word die are attached to each other. So it's really unique and a very cool die that I think actually just looked beautiful anyway I tried it. So I'm going to go ahead and get started in creating my card front. I'm going to be using Flirty Fuchsia, Coral Cabana, and Bellini, and these are all inks from Catherine Pooler. And I'm going to be using a technique or a method that I learned recently from a Christina Werner video, and I'm going to be making an ombre effect, and I loved the way that she did those cards or the card fronts, so I'm going to be using that for inspiration today. To blend, I'm using the Trinity Stamps blendability brushes, and these brushes really just make ink blending absolutely a breeze. So I'm going to be using a very light hand, and I'm going to speed this up a little bit because the one thing about these brushes that I will say is that it takes quite a while to get a good saturation onto the paper. It's beautiful and it comes out really nice and clean, and the blend is perfect almost every single time, but you do use a very light hand, and maybe that's the reason that the saturation takes a long time to build. So I was going back and forth a lot with the colors. So again, I started with Flirty Fuchsia, I went into Coral Cabana, and then I ended with Bellini. And so anytime I started to blend a color of ink over the previous color, I went back in again with the previous color to do the blend where they met over again. And if that doesn't make any sense, you can see there what I'm doing. I just always make sure to go back in with that previous color just to make sure that where the two colors meet gets a really good blend and it almost makes a new color. You don't want the blend to be purple to pink or purple to orange. You want it to sort of look like it created this new color in the middle of those two, and that's when you get the really nice colorful blend. So now I am just about done with that, and I really love the way that it all turned out. It reminds me of a sunset. And now I'm going to start to set up how I'm going to stamp the background stamp. So what I'm going to do first is take a heat gun and make sure that this entire card panel is dry. Because there's so much ink on the card panel when I did the ink blending, it's possible when I'm doing my heat embossing that the embossing powder will stick to the sort of more saturated or wetter spots. So just to make sure that that's not going to happen, I'm going to take some embossing powder and put it right over the top of my card front without any stamping first. And if all of the embossing powder falls off, then it's dry and it won't stick anywhere. And then I didn't go ahead and ruin it by having to wipe all of the embossing powder off if I had tried stamping it first. So I'm going to go ahead and place this in my Misti, and you'll see that I put some repositionable adhesive onto the back side of my cardstock, and that is so I can rest it in the center of the Misti without needing to put my background stamp up against the sides of the Misti. There are also creative corners for the Misti, but I don't have them, so I just use a repositionable adhesive and it works out great. I'm going to use this embossing buddy powder bag, and this is to make sure that none of the embossing powder will stick where I don't want it to. So I'm going to use Versamark ink to ink up my background stamp, and I do this for a little bit because it is a fairly large stamp and there's a lot of space to cover here. And I planned on stamping this twice anyway, which is another reason that I put it in my Misti, because you absolutely could just lay the background stamp down and put your cardstock right on top of it and sort of use your cardstock as the stamping part. But I knew that I wanted to go ahead and emboss this twice, just so I got that really nice, bold, white line, and also so that the embossing looked a little smoother. Double embossing and triple embossing helps that effect. I'm going to go ahead now and use my paper hug die, and you can see I cut the shadow part out of a white cardstock. And to make an ombre effect or sort of like a multiple color effect. I'm going to go right from ink pad to paper, and I'm going to use the same three colors, and I'll just overlap them again just to make a blend. It's not going to be a perfect blend, but because I am cutting out a word die, you're not going to need the effect to be so seamless. So I'm going to go ahead and put that word die right in the center just to make sure I get all of the colors there. And then I put it through my die cutting machine and use my Spellbinders tool in one to help take out all of the pieces just to get them out nice and gently and make sure that I don't tear any of them apart. I'm going to go ahead now and adhere the word die and the letters to the shadow die. And this is where my camera decided to turn off. So I'm going to go ahead and just tell you a little bit about what I did. As you can see, obviously, I used that shadow die and word die on another card. I decided that the card front with the ink blend with this word die wasn't enough contrast, and it wasn't as legible as I wanted it to be. So I went ahead and put it on a white piece of cardstock and then onto a white card base, and I added some colorful sequins and a little black sentiment strip. And this is an accidental card, and it happens to be probably one of my favorite that I've ever made. So it's happy accidents today. For the original card front that I went ahead and ink blended, I used a very dark purple for my shadow base die, and then a nice crisp white cardstock for my word die. I think that it just looks a lot better. It's very legible. There's a lot of contrast there, and you'll notice that I was holding it originally with the purple at the top, but I switched it because I thought the light orange with the dark purple shadow dye sort of would give that really nice contrast. I added a very light orange sentiment strip and then put a white cardstock behind that so that it popped out a little bit, and again just made it a little bit more legible. And you might notice that I went ahead and trimmed an eighth of an inch off of either side of the ink blended card front lengthwise. So you'll see the white card base peeking out from the left and the right, but not the top or the bottom. And I just thought that looked really nice. I hope that you've enjoyed learning about how I created these cards today. As always, links to my blog, Instagram, Pinterest, and all of the supplies and products used are in the description. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I'll see you again very soon. Thank you. Bye.